This show has discovered every kind of star. Award-winning pop stars.
And the Grammy goes to Kelly Clarkson.
Double platinum-selling rock artists. Award-winning country stars.
Oh my gosh.
Stars of Broadway.
I'm going to be starring in The Color Purple. Thanks.
And even movie stars.
And the Oscar goes to
Jennifer Hudson.
So many people, so many different talents, but they shared the same spotlight. All of them won the hearts of America on our top 12 stage.
For this year's top 12, to show us what they can do, we're giving them the best platform in the history of television. Will you give them your vote? This is American Idol. Hello there. Welcome to American Idol. I'm Ryan Seacrest. It is Tuesday night. We are live, and it's so good to be back on this stage. It's all tricked out. Take a look at this place, huh? Looks good, doesn't it? This is our home for the next 3 months as we narrow down the numbers to find that one superstar. But that's not all. We've got a much bigger band. Take it away, guys. Hit it. We've added the horns and the strings. Looking good, gentlemen. Looking good, ladies. Plus, we've opened the doors to a massive live audience. Say hi, everybody. And here are your top 12. Brandon Rogers. Melinda Doolittle. Chris Sly. Gina Glockson, Sanjaya Malakar, Haley Scarnato, Phil Stacy, Lakeisha Jones, Blake Lewis, Stephanie Edwards, Chris Richardson, and Jordan Sparks. There they are. One of them, the next American Idol. And we couldn't do any of this without the people who found our contestants in the first place. Let's hear it for your judges. Randy Jackson. Woo! Paula Abdul. And Simon Cowell. Woo! Randy, here we go with the top 12. The guys and the girls on the same stage together for the first time live. How do you think the guys will respond?
Man, I hope they bring their game, man. So far for me on my scorecard, the girls are ahead. So you got to be in it to win it at this point, dawg.
And Paula, what do you think of the top 12 this year?
I think we have a great variety. I think that the girls have been shining, but I think the guys are ready to come into their own now.
Simon, what do you think? Will the guys be showing up tonight?
Well, this is the time where they could be. This stage changes everybody, yep. Ryan. You know, it's a whole different ball game. It can either, I've said this before, make you or break you.
Well, tonight we're celebrating the music and career of a true industry legend. Take a look at this.
Diana Ross is the most successful female recording artist of all time. Her incredible music career spans over 40 years. At the age of 15, she fronted an all-girl group that came to earn the name The Supremes. They had 12 number one hits and were the most successful American music group of the 60s. Later, Ross broke away from the group and found success on her own as a performer and an actress. I'm coming out. I want
won a Golden Globe for her role as Billie Holiday in Lady Sings the Blues. She's also received a Tony Award, 12 Grammy nominations, and even has 2 stars on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. She's dominated the charts with over 80 top 10 hits in nearly every genre of music, from soul to pop to disco and adult contemporary. Her boundless energy on stage, unique fashion sense, and mass appeal made her Billboard's honoree for Female Entertainer of the Century. So it's only fitting that our first musical mentor is one that reigns supreme. The legend herself took time out from her latest tour rehearsals to meet with our top 12 and coach them through the songs she made famous.
Look at your smiling faces. So good to see you. Hello, hello.
I was able in my career to have great mentors. My mother was a great mentor for me. She believed in me. Berry Gordy was a great mentor for me. He believed in me, even when I didn't believe in myself.
I have one thing to say. I am not a critic. I feel like I am your trusting voice and hopefully the supporting voice. I'd like to see you all be successful past this show to have longevity. Like, I've had a career for 4 decades. And I want you guys to be able to have that regardless of whether it's American Idol or the rest of your life.
I have truly enjoyed this experience working with the contestants. One of the things that I truly am deep in my heart is a parent. And in a sense, mentoring is part of parenting, that I want very much for them to be able to leave here and have a life that is fulfilling for them.
She wants the best for them, but remember, you are in control. Who will win your vote tonight? The competition starts now with Brandon.
I think it really helps to have a mentor like Diana Ross. I've been exposed to a lot of different celebrities doing what I do for a living, but Diana's a different breed. She is, you know, the star to which a lot of stars are compared to. You know, she's the original.
I'm nervous.
You can sit or stand. I think they don't care. I like Brandon very much. He said he grew up on Can't Hurry Love.
I need love, love to ease my mind.
I recorded this song in the early days with the Supremes. It was the Motown sound.
You can't hurry love.
All right, real good.
So that made me feel good to have this superstar telling me that I was good. You know, it's like, that's huge. This is Diana Ross we're talking about.
I'm just amazed at the amount of work that you guys have to do every day, all the time.
Everyone's doing a great job, I mean, with the nerves.
Like. Yeah, just go back to your center, you know? You know, go to your center, your heart place, you know?
Yeah.
Okay? All right.
Thank you.
Real good.
So awesome.
Okay.
And we're going all the way back to 1966 for this number one smash. With You Can't Hurry Love, here is Brandon Rogers.
I need love, love to ease my mind. I need to find someone to call mine. Well, my mama said you can't hurry love. No, you just have to wait. She said love don't come easy. It's a game of give and take. You can't hurry love. No, you just have to wait. She said trust, give it time. No matter how long it takes, but how many heartaches must I stand before I find the love that makes me live again? Right now the only thing that keeps me hanging on when I feel my strength. It's a game of give and take. How long must I wait? How much more can I take before loneliness will cause my heart to break? Now break. Now love, I grow impatient for a love to call my own, but when I feel I remember mama said, you can't hurt.
Brandon. Yo, baby. All right, so this is the start of the future for everybody. It's a Big 12 night. Everybody got to be in it to win it. Dog, man, you came out like you had reverted back to a background singer for me. Like, it was kind of boring, uninteresting. You forgot the words. But at the very end, the last two notes of the song, you sounded like you wanted to be in front. Dog, it's got to be a lot better than that for me, man.
It's not easy to do what you're doing, especially the first night out here. And I know nerves play a big part of it.
Yeah.
Going into from a small in the round now into a big concert hall like this. But, you know, Brandon, we don't need to tell you what you did wrong. There are many things that you do right. And I think that you'll warm up into this.
That was a complete letdown, actually, Brandon. It was a very...
Here we go. Very predictable version, predictable arrangement. The dancing was terrible. You forgot the words. And you came over, if you don't mind me saying, as a background singer for a background singer.
Hey,
that's how it came over. No star quality in that performance, no originality. Absolutely not good enough. Sorry.
Brandon Rogers taking a beating from the judging table right now. All right, well, let's talk about it for a second. As you were doing it, did you feel like it was going your way or not?
I felt it was going my way until I forgot the words.
Yeah, at that point, you probably thought, oops.
I thought, oops, but I tried to pick it up as best as I could.
Is it the fact that we're on this stage now? I mean, this is the first time you guys have been on a stage like this in this competition.
Mm-hmm.
Does it affect you?
Yeah, I think it's kind of amazing to be out here. The whole crowd cheering and everything. I think I just
you get caught up in it a little bit.
I got a little caught up in it and enjoying it a little too much, and nerves coming to play. So.
And how about going first tonight? How did that affect you?
Well, I knew I had to bring it, and apparently I didn't do my best. So I'll try to do better next time if I'm given the opportunity.
Okay. Well, it's up to America. For Brandon, 1-866-IDOL-01. 1-866-436-5701, or if you're with Singular Wireless, now part of the new AT&T, text the word VOTE to 5701. You'll have at least 2 hours at the end of the show. Give it up for Brandon one more time. Good luck, buddy, all right? Thank you, sir. We are going to take a break. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, Melinda and Chris. Hang on. Back with you now live on American Idol. You know the drill. 12 singers, you vote for your favorite at the end of the show. But this season, you can ask your favorite questions as well. Go to AmericanIdol.com, click on My Coke Rewards, and find out how you can ask a question to an idol. Melinda Doolittle with me right now. How are you? Good. So let's see. We've got a question from Sonyette Cross in Austell, Georgia. Sonia wants to know, what do you consider the hardest part of this contest?
Wow. I would have to say the high heels and these dresses. I like my tennis shoes and my sweatpants. I'm sorry.
Simon, any advice on the high heels?
You should know, Ryan.
Stay out of my closet.
Come out.
This is about the top 12, okay? Not your wishes. We're friends. Let's take a look at Diana and Melinda in action. Good luck, babe.
Thank you. It's such a pleasure to meet you.
My pleasure to meet you.
Goodness. I am an old school Motown girl at heart, so people like Diana Ross are just huge to me.
I am such a big fan.
I've heard so much about you.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. It was all good.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
And just maybe I... When I sing Home, I think about my world changing. It's like the perfect thing for what's going on right now.
In my life to grow up.
When she started to sing the words, you believed it? I think the audience will feel that. I did.
Well done. Well done. When you sing, I get goosebumps.
I was really excited about that because I assume goosebumps are good.
Real good, baby. Real good.
Whether she wins or not, she will continue to persevere. I feel that.
Will you believe in her too? With Home from The Wiz, here she is, Melinda Doolittle.
And just maybe I can convince time to slow up, giving me enough time in my life to grow up. Time be my friend. Let me start again. Suddenly my world's gone and changed its face, but I still know where I'm going. I have had my mind spun around in space, and yet I watched it growing. Oh, if you're listening, God, please don't make it hard to know if we should believe the things that we see. Tell us, should we run away? Should we try and stay? Or would it be better just to let things be? Living here in this brand new world might be a fantasy, but it's taught me to love, so it's real, real to me. And I've learned that we must look inside our hearts to find a world full of love like yours, like mine, like
Miss Melinda Doolittle. Yo. All right, so check it out. I gotta say, I don't know if it was my favorite performance of yours, but it was still really, really strong. So for that performance, I give the girls one, the boys zero. That was hot, baby.
Melinda, just watching you, I feel what you're just feeling so much joy, and it's exciting. I feel I'm one big goosebump, and I just am so excited for you because look at you. I mean, this is it for you. This is it for you. You're selling for it.
Simon?
Lost.
Are you at a loss for words? What's happening?
When you see her crying
like
that.
No, I'm sneezing. I'm sorry.
You're sneezing, yeah.
Sorry.
Why are you crying, Melinda?
That's what touches her.
I never heard anything like that from
you. Yeah.
Look, Melinda, I mean, you've even made... I've always thought that song was quite boring. You've always made that song, which... I can't do what I'm talking about. You're making me laugh, Paula. You made a very boring song, fantastic. You know who you remind me of? You remind me of a young Gladys Knight. Very, very good. Very good.
Once again. So, darling, a sensory overload, huh?
Oh my gosh, I can't. Oh my gosh.
Well, talk about what you feel when you're up there and when you were singing that song moments ago.
I don't remember it.
Paula, you're an artist. What did she feel when she was up there in front of all these people?
She's feeling like she had an out-of-body experience.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay. You're feeling like you had an out-of-body experience.
Thank you.
Good news, because that dress is such a pain, right?
Yeah.
If you want to vote for Melinda, 1-866-IDOL-02. 1-866-436-5702, or you can text the word VOTE to 5702. Standard text messaging rates apply. Thank you very much, Melinda. Good to see you tonight. All right, next, it is Chris.
My first impression of Chris is that he was a little bit nervous.
Hi, my name is Chris.
I don't really have the nervous bone in my body. I see that we have very similar hair. It's
yes,
exciting.
Yes, we do.
I just can't get mine to go as much out like that.
Got to tease. You got yeah.
to. I'll see what I can do. That's going to be great. Well, I'm going to do Endless Love, I think, and give it a little bit of a different feel.
Good,
and,
okay.
See how you like it.
Okay.
Awesome.
I'm sure I will.
My love, there's only you in my life. When you listen to that song, it doesn't sound extremely modern. And so I changed some of the chords around.
Can I give you one comment?
Yes, please.
The music is about going to the heart. With Endless Love, it's important that you find the melody in there and hold on to it. I think Chris needs to just listen more to the melody of the song and find that hook. That is the thing that will sell this song, and it will sell him.
Well, they share the hair. Can he make this song his own? With Endless Love, here is Chris Sly.
My love, it's only you in my life, the only thing that's bright. My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make, oh, and I want to share all my love with you, no one else will do.
What's up, baby? So this is the new Top 12 Chris. No glasses, the whole look. Dude, I gotta tell you, man, the bad part of that for me was like, you know, sounded like Coldplay, Speed of Sound a little bit. Was a weird thing to do to that song because, like, you, the melody changed everywhere. But you have to not worry so much about the style and just sing your heart out. You got a good voice, but that was a mess for me. Yeah.
Well, that's all right. That song is so recognizable, and it's such a beautiful love song. And sometimes I worry that you're trying ultra hard to be ultra hip and cool. And sometimes you just can just let the melody play, listen to the lyrics, sing the song, because you have a really nice voice. I worry less of trying to fit into some kind of contemporary thing here.
Chris, I think you murdered the arrangement, personally. I do. I think you turned a beautiful song into a complete and utter drone. I really do. I found it complete. Even the booze are light. I thought it was just...
What?
The booze. I thought it was just unemotional, uninspiring, and I would keep your glasses on. Because I think it's you.
Chris Sly. Some candid feedback from the judges. Did you ever think you'd be on a stage singing a Diana Ross song?
No.
Never when you were a little boy, huh?
No. You know, I have a lot of respect for Diana Ross, but I went with my gut, and, you know, I felt like it was a good arrangement, but obviously, you know, the judges, and I respect their opinions, so.
What do you think about what they said?
I think that it had a lot more to do with the arrangement of the song than it did the vocal, but, I mean, obviously that's part of the whole,
right.
The whole thing. So hopefully next week, if America allows me, I'll come back and try to do something that's arranged a little bit better.
Well, it's up to you guys watching at home. For Chris, 1-866-IDOL-03, 1-866-436-5703, or text the word VOTE to 5703. Thank you very much, Chris Sly, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to duck out for a few. When we come back, we have Gina live. Back with you, Idol. We are live and celebrating the music of Diana Ross. One person leaves us live tomorrow. Remember, it's your call that counts. Next up is a star-struck Gina. Here we go.
Hello, Miss Ross. It's so great to meet you.
When I first walked in the room and was one-on-one with Diana Ross, it was so crazy because she's a legend.
Just a little starstruck, sorry.
No.
Well, I'm going to be singing Love Child.
Okay.
I have a story about this song. When I was like 4 years old, my parents have a videotape of me singing on my little star stage, and they're like, do you even know what this song's about? I'm like, no, but I like it.
Gina, to me, has incredible vocal ability.
Love Child, never quite as good.
The thing that I wanted to remind her of was pronunciation. Because there's so many words, you must pronunciate everything.
Okay. She told me that her song is a story, and don't leave any words out. Don't die out on the end of phrases.
You can't say love, blah, 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 blah. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So you got to pronunciate, you got to project.
I will definitely take Miss Ross's advice and run with it.
I wish you well. I really
do. Thank you so much. I
appreciate it. Okay. All right.
All right.
Another number one for Diana with the Supremes back in 1968, singing Love Child. Here is Gina.
You think that I don't feel love. What I feel for you is real love. In other eyes, I see rejected, hurt, scorn, rejected love child. Never meant to be love child. Born in poverty, love child. Never meant to be love child. Take a look at me. I started school in a warm, torn dress that somebody threw out, and I knew just what it meant. Afraid my friends would see the guilt in me. Don't think that I don't need ya. Don't think I don't wanna please ya. But no child of mine will be bearing the name of shame. I've been wearing love, child. Always stuck in bed. Love, child. Different from the rest. Love, child. Never quite as good. Afraid, ashamed.
Yo. All right, so once again for me, I got a feeling I might be saying this a lot tonight. It wasn't my favorite performance from you because I'm a Gina fan, but it was pitchy in spots. I don't know. I didn't feel any excitement from you with that song. It's like it felt very boring for me. You know what I mean? Just I don't know. It was weird.
Well, it's such an exciting song. I mean, that song is like a feel good. You can't help yourself. You want to get up. I feel that. You're much better than how you did tonight. And I feel like at times you were shouting and enunciation and pitch were kind of off.
Okay.
Gina, it was okay. I mean, it's one of those performances you actually can't say much about, really. I mean, it wasn't terrible. It wasn't fantastic. I think you chose the right song for you.
Yeah.
I think it's good that you've stayed in this image again, which I think suits you. But it really is a little bit forgettable, and that's why I'm saying there's not much we can say about it, really. I think it was a middle-pack performance.
Okay. Gina Glockson. Hello.
Hi.
So how'd you feel up on the stage tonight?
It felt good. It's the first time on the huge stage and all these people, but it felt good. I still feel at home on the stage, just a bit bigger.
Well, you at home, if you want to vote for Gina, 1-866-IDOL-04, 1-866-436-5704, or text the word VOTE to 5704. Don't call until the end of the show. Thank you, Gina.
Thank
good luck,
you.
Okay?
Thanks.
Coming up, Sanjaya has a mountain to climb. It's After the Break live. We are back on American Idol. What will the top 12 deliver tonight? Next up, it is Sanjaya. Here we go.
Sanjaya to me is love. I mean, you care about him. Give me a hug.
Being able to have Diana Ross mentor you, it's like having Van Gogh teach you how to paint. Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low.
He started this song, Ain't No Mountain High Enough, right off the bat, without any bars to set it up.
A second, let's stop.
If you're going to do it like that, you're going to have to be really point on.
Yeah.
You know, like, mm-hmm. ba-ba-da. I didn't feel that he was on the beat. This is one of my favorite ones, you know? And you were, at the beginning, you were good. Do you tap your feet or anything?
She told me that I just need to move around and just, like, have fun. Just feel it in my body.
You better get your soul in there. Can you dance? There's something in his spirit that is the winning ingredient. And it's not his hair, okay?
All right, this was Diana's first U.S. number one as a solo artist. Can Sanjaya own it tonight? Ain't no mountain high enough. Here is Sanjaya Malakar.
Mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby. If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far. Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry, cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Just send for me, oh baby.
Ain't no mountain high enough.
Oh,
ain't no valley low enough.
Yeah, yeah.
Ain't no river wide enough
to keep me from you. Ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting.
Sanjaya, what's going down, dude? What is really going down, dog? Yo, man. Wow. I am really, dude, I don't even know what to say, man. I'm like, dude, it wasn't very good. It really wasn't, man. It really wasn't. You know, listen, thank God for the background singers because that song was almost unlistenable for me, man. It was really, really weak. But you know what I love about you? You know what I look forward to, man? Every week, dude, you throwing down some different dudes with the hair, man. The hair is rocking, though. Dude, hair idol, you got it jumping off, man. I'm saying, you know what I mean?
Sanjaya, I can understand why Diana said you're pure love, because you are. You are the sweetest soul. You smile, and it it warms people's hearts. It really does. I mean, it wasn't that you sang on pitch. I understand what Diana was saying. You have to start it off where you really got to grab the audience. And when a song like that happens, you got to just let go. And I think that's the thing we try to say is you got to explode with your vocals now. You got to really jump out, reckless abandon, and go. You look adorable, though.
The hair is popping, though. The hair is popping.
He didn't do a bad job.
He can't. Look, when you hear a whale in Beverly Hills, that is where Diana Ross is watching this show.
What?
She's going to freak when she hears that. The only similarity is the hairstyle. I don't know what else to say. I mean, it was... Look, okay, Sanjay, I'll be positive. How old are you?
Huh?
How old are you?
17.
Right, you're very brave. I'll give you that. You're brave.
The courage of Sanjaya Malakar. I think we're dying to know what's going on in your head when you're listening to them give you feedback tonight.
I don't even know. I
mean,
yeah. Well, no, I listen to the positive things, but sometimes, no offense, Simon, but your first comment, I had no idea what you're talking about.
Okay. When she listens to this on TV,
she'll
scream.
Okay.
He wasn't talking about the marine biology aspect of sea life. It's more of an audible sound from... Okay. Well, good luck. Do you feel like you should be here next week?
Yeah.
Okay. If you do at home as well, Sanjaya's number, 1-866-IDOL-05, 1-866-436-5705, or you can text the word VOTE to 5705. Thank you very much, Sanjaya.
Thank you, man.
Appreciate it. Commercials coming at you. When we come back, it is Haley live on IDOL. Back with you on American Idol. We are all about Diana Ross tonight. Tomorrow, she is performing live right here on Idol, so tune in for that. Here's Haley Scarnato, ladies and gentlemen. And another viewer question. Let's see, this is from Nicole Rice in Texas. Where's the craziest place you ever sang?
You know, it has to be here. This night is so intense. Like, we're backstage and we're just freaking out. It truly is so intense. And going from a small stage to a big stage with the lights and the bigger band, it's just, it's incredible, the feeling. And I remember, like, when I first stepped foot on stage, that will always stay true to my heart, but nothing will ever compare to this.
It's pretty intense, huh?
In
the waiting room back there, is anybody speaking?
Yeah, I mean, we're speaking, but it's just, we're like this, you know, and we're like cold and drinking water. We're doing anything and everything, but we're just really nervous, so.
Water, and there's always Coca-Cola available. Take a look at your masterclass. What's this?
How are you?
I'm good.
You're good.
I'm
beautiful. You really are good.
I'm singing Missing You. I picked it because I think it would show a little bit more emotion.
Ooh, I'm missing you. She has a recording studio voice as compared to a live audience projection. Her voice was too much inside. What are you thinking about when you sing that song?
I'm actually thinking of my fiancé.
Yeah?
Yes. Yeah. He's back at home.
Yeah. I recorded that song after Marvin Gaye's death, and we were brokenhearted about his death, and we were missing him. It's good to have thoughts behind the songs, and I think the audience reads that and feels that.
My goal tonight is definitely to enjoy the song and sing every word and truly mean the word, because the lyrics are beautiful, and to have fun and not stress out about little things and just kind of just have fun out there.
Let's hope it's fun for you, too, with Missing You. Here is Haley Scarnato.
Since you've been away, I've been down and lonely. Since you've been away, I've been thinking of you. Try to understand the reason you left me. What were you going?
Sometimes I wondered, I didn't understand just where you ought to go. Oh, you knew no more than that you can only be.
You already know what I'm gonna say, right? Well, listen, I mean, listen, you gave it a valiant effort. I mean, it just, you know, forgetting the words and stuff. And I think you sounded a little nervous when you started, because, I mean, you know, it was all pitchy and all over the place, and usually your pitch is better than that. So just a little surprised, a little shocked.
Mm. Well, I'll start with saying you look lovely tonight. Yeah. Yeah, you heard that. But Haley, that's probably not what you want to hear so far. You know, again, it's the same thing with Brandon. It's a brand new day up here, and forgetting the words is never a great thing to do. And your pitch, yay. You're still adorable. You know, I mean, this is hard. This is a hard thing. What can I say?
I didn't think it was that bad. No, you know, to give you credit, Haley, I think we will remember you now. I think you had real presence up there. I do. I think you had real presence. I think you look like a star. I think your nerves got the better of you halfway through the song. But if you can just hold it together. You may do better than I thought you were going to do, because I think you, as I said, very, very impressed with your presence on stage tonight. And there were moments of your vocals I liked it.
It's okay to let it out.
No, it's not.
Let it out, and then we'll reset.
Oh, sure.
Yeah? So how do you feel in this moment right now? A little relieved.
I feel like I'm like going like this.
All right, so here, if you'd like a stool, there's one prepared right for you there. Okay? That's good. If you'd like to vote for Haley, that's good. That's good news. You should feel good.
I messed up my words and I feel like such a schmuck because, you know, I mean, it is what it is. But Simon and everybody, like, it means so much to actually get a good, you know, something good from you guys.
It can push.
And I feel like this was like the worst performance just because I messed up my words, but it truly does mean so much to me.
Really, half the time the audience never knows that you've messed up. They don't know anything, so never let them see anything like that.
Yeah. If you want to vote for Haley, it's 1-866-8006, 1-866-436-5706, or text the word vote to 5706. Good luck.
Thank you.
You've made it through it. We're going to disappear for a few moments. We'll be back with Phil Stacey. Hang on. Back with you on American Idol. Halfway through the most emotional show to date. Wouldn't you agree?
Absolutely. I do agree.
Tears, excitement, and some good performers, huh?
I've even got chills several times. It was so good.
Well, it's only a two-hour show. I'd ask you more, but we've got to keep moving.
Okay, chills. It was so good.
It's good to have you with us. That's my Nana. We've got a great live audience, and now it's time for Phil Stacey. Take it away, Phil.
Hello, Ms. Ross. I'm Phil Stacey.
Hi, Phil. How are you doing?
It's such an honor to sing for you today. When I went out to meet Diana Ross, I didn't have much of a game plan. I was just, I wanted to get the song right.
I'm gonna shower you with love and affection.
direction.
I really do like the song that he selected. It's a song that I did with Marvin Gaye, and he brought back memories for me.
Yes, I will.
One of the things that I've had an issue with is just gathering myself and getting in the right mindset before I go out on the stage. And so I asked for her advice.
You know what seems to really, really help me is looking at the audience. They're really real people with same feelings like you have and everything.
Thank you so much, Ms. Ross.
You're very welcome. You're very welcome.
I think that this week I'm going to start a lot differently and a lot more confident.
He is confident, but will he make you love him? Ladies and gentlemen, Phil Stacey.
I'm gonna do all the things for you a girl would like a man to do. Oh, baby. I'll sacrifice for you. I'll even do wrong for you. Oh, baby, yeah. Every minute, every hour, I'm gonna shower you with love and affection. Look out, baby, it's coming in your direction. Yes, and I'm gonna make you love me. Oh, yes, I will. Yes, I will. Never get tired of me, oh baby. Every night and every day, oh, I'm gonna stay. Girl, I'm gonna get you, I'm gonna get you. Look out, girl, cause I'm gonna get you.
Phil, what's up, baby? You glad that's over? How you think you did, dog? What did you think of that?
I thought it was pretty good.
All right, well, listen, I'll tell you the positive. I'll tell you the coolest thing for you, man, is that the performance was a little boring, but your voice, you get the Boys Award for the night, man. The vocals were hot. The vocals, you were on blast, man. You were on blast with the vocals, man. I love that.
We were discussing that while you're performing. Your vocals sound really good. We were feeling it needs to be a little more up-tempo, and it would have been a more exciting performance. Yeah. Okay. Other than that, though, Phil, you have strong vocals. You really
vocals
do.
Vocals are hot, baby.
No, I think you were wrong, Paula. That shouldn't be an up-tempo song. He chose the right tempo.
It should have
a little bit more tempo to it.
Whatever.
Yeah, we're right.
Okay, listen to me now, Paula. It was okay. I think it was a very good choice of song for you. There, you have a tendency, though, that when you're trying to hit the big notes, you shout. So it's like you're shouting in my ear, and somehow you've got to control that. It wasn't outstanding. It wasn't awful. Again, it was somewhere in the middle. I think it was better than last week, though. I'll hand that to you.
I thought it was really good.
Yeah.
It was really good.
Phil Stacey. Yeah, take that, man. Take that and build. If you want to vote for Phil, 1-866-IDOL-07. 1-866-436-5707. Or you can text the word vote to 5707. Calls are toll-free from landlines. Thank you very much, Phil. Good luck to you, all right?
All right.
We're coming back live in Hollywood with LaKeisha, hang on. Back with you live on Idol. Who will win your vote at the end of the show? Are you ready for LaKeisha?
It's not every day you get to meet a superstar. She's more than a star, she's a superstar.
How you doing?
What does your mama call you?
Kiki.
Kiki?
Yeah.
I've never sang God Bless the Child before. Never even looked at the lyrics until last night.
Them that's God shall get.
It's a Billie Holiday song. I think she wrote it while on tour, or when I did the movie Lady Sings the Blues, that's how we had the song in the film. Because of this song, you know what it is, Billie Holiday and all that, I think you should wear something long but very simple.
Would you suggest not having a mic stand or not having a mic stand?
I had to think about that because that's an important thought. I'm thinking a mic and sing because that way both your arms could be down. You don't have to, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Because you can bring them to you. It says to me that she's thinking about how she should perform it.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Thanks.
Okay. I am really looking forward to seeing what Kiki decides to do.
Call her Kiki, call her Lakeisha. Just make sure you call at the end of the show. With God Bless the Child, here is Lakeisha.
Them that's got shall get, them that's not shall lose. So the Bible says, and it still lives in news. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own. That's got his own. Ooh. Oh, money. Then you've got lots of friends crowding around your door. But when the money's gone and the spending ends, oh, they don't come around no more. No, 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 no more. Rich relations give a crust of bread and such. Oh, you can help yourself, but don't take too much, don't take it. Mama may have, and you, your daddy may have, but God bless the child that's got his own.
Lakeisha, Lakeisha. Wow. They're yelling for Kiki. Kiki's in the house. All right, so check it out. Check it out. Perfect song choice for you. I love the outfit. And check it out. Unbelievable vocal from you because you didn't overdo it and you could have easily gone it because you got that big old voice. That was sensational.
You're a beautiful performer, you're a beautiful girl, and you have your heart comes through when you sing. And that's the most important thing you can possess as an artist.
Lakeisha, you've either got it or you haven't got it. You've got it. I mean, there's the difference. I have to say, the quality difference between you and Melinda compared to the other singers we've heard so far, it's you two are in a different league. And why that was so, and I totally agree with what Randy said, it was a very, very controlled performance.
Yeah.
But you didn't look intimidated by this big stage,
right,
or the big orchestra. You were very much in control, performed like a star, outstanding.
That is what we want to hear, Lakeisha. Well, I know you feel good after that. So Simon says that you've got it. Do you feel like you're comfortable with it?
I'm getting it.
Yeah?
I'm getting it.
How did you feel on the inside when you were singing that?
A little nervous. A little bit.
Well, you didn't
I'm
show
so
it.
Used
singing so loud and so big and just wanted to kind of tone it down just a little bit.
Good control tonight.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you very much. If you want to vote for LaKeisha, 1-866-8008. 1-866-436-5708 or text the word VOTE 5708. That is LaKeisha.
Thank you.
Coming up, we've got a modern spin on a Motown classic. Blake Lewis is on after the break. Welcome back to American Idol Live. Blake Lewis, ladies and gentlemen, in the house. And Blake,
yes.
Another viewer question from Jay Taylor in Sumner, Washington. The question, what type of music do you listen to in your spare time?
To Jay Taylor, I listen to a lot of underground hip-hop, electronic music, Common Market, The Mob Law, Panda Conspiracy.
You have enough time to do all that?
Oh, yeah.
And who's your favorite artist of all time?
Favorite artist of all time? That's really tough. It's got to be MJ, Michael Jackson.
Got it.
Prince, good performers. Just anyone that can perform really well, I really like. So.
Well, hopefully that's you tonight performing very
hopefully,
well, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck. Let's see what happened with Diana.
Hey, Blake.
Hi.
How are you?
Pleasure to meet you.
And you too.
To get prepared for this, I got on my computer and I took the song and I put new beats to it and slowed it down and kind of just tried to make it my own.
Set me free, why don't you, babe? Get out my life, why don't you, babe?
Blake was doing a song that I did in the 60s, and he was bringing it from the 60s to today, and you need to make it fresh.
Trying
so
to.
I like seeing what you're going to do with it. I look forward to it, in
cool.
fact.
The song's been covered a lot. I definitely hope that she sees that I took her piece from the 60s, and now it's 2007, that I just, you know, revamped it, and I really just hope she really likes it.
Now, this song's so popular, it's been inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame with his own spin on You Keep Me Hanging On. Here is Blake.
Set me free, why don't you, baby? Get out my life, why don't you, baby? 'Cause you don't really love me, you just keep me hanging on. Why do you keep coming around, playing with my heart? Why don't you get out of my life and let me make a new start? Let me get over you the way you've gotten over me. Hey, set me free, why don't you, baby? Get out my life, why don't you, baby? 'Cause you don't really love me, you just keep me hanging on. You say although we broke up, you still wanna be just friends. But how can we still be friends when seeing you only breaks my heart again? And there's nothing I can do about it. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
So, yo, check it out, dog. Check it out. Check it out. Blake, you know I'm a huge fan, right?
Thanks.
Dog is a huge fan of Blake's. Okay, look, there were some good things about it. I mean, you know, classic songs like this, you don't have to necessarily change the arrangement. Like, you don't have to worry about Blake eyes in every song. You like that word, Blake eyes, right? So, but check it out, because, I mean, you actually sing better than that. So sometimes let the vocals do your thing. You're a great performer. I mean, you know, you're modern, you're hip, you're cool. So, I mean, sometimes you can let the classics be the classics, you know what I mean?
Yes.
No,
I understand what you're saying totally, and I do agree to a certain extent, but there's a difference, I feel, between what Blake did and what Chris Sly did. And I think I think what seeing you and letting the audience see how you actually work it out and you think about it, I think that you could have a hit with that again. I really do.
You just got to put more vocals in it. That was the only thing I didn't like.
Yeah,
there was not enough for you.
You are a good singer.
Better than
you're
that,
a real good singer, too.
Really?
Yeah.
You can work it out. Come on, huh?
Blake, I didn't get that. I didn't get it at all. I understand. I understand why you wanted to put your own take on it, which is fair enough. But if you had heard that in isolation, if you heard that version as we heard that on the radio, you wouldn't like it. Because that song was written in a particular style. It didn't work changing the melody like that. You didn't sound as good as we've heard you previously either. Yeah. So
he's a classic. Simon's right. They don't need changing.
And you know what's interesting is that at Motown, you don't need to change anything.
These are classics.
You really get Motown, and we love Motown sound. That's what.
You'll be fine, Blake. But
Blake Lewis. So do you regret then changing it so much after hearing that?
No, not at all. I just wanted to put my kind of feel to it, you know, maybe a little more electronic vibe to it, you know.
Do you get what they're saying about the vocals, though? They're saying go for it.
Yeah, I do, definitely.
Okay, if you want to vote for Blake, 1-866-IDOL-09, 1-866-436-5709, or text the word VOTE to 5709. Thank you and good luck, Blake.
Thank you so much.
Okay, buddy. Three more coming up, then you can vote. Stephanie Edwards and Chris Richardson on after the break. Uh-huh. Welcome back to American Idol. Live results tomorrow night.
Put it in your pocket. Carry on.
Yeah.
You realize this is a live telecast, right?
Central. Be there for the drama.
Lots of drama tomorrow. Like there's not enough tonight.
Back to tonight.
Are you ready for Stephanie?
Yes.
Okay, watch this.
I am going to be singing Love Hangover.
How are you?
I'm honored to meet you.
Okay.
This is definitely the biggest mentor session for me because I am in love with Diana Ross.
Got you all in my heart, in my head, and I just can't get out of the bed. Baby,
my notes for Stephanie had to do with the song being delivered with a meaning of a little bit sexy quality. You know, where you start off sexy and then you build up a little bit and then...
Okay, I'm gonna really take her advice to heart. I am. She's Diana Ross.
If there's a cure for this.
She's a tiny little thing, you know? It reminded me so much of me when I started off. I think she has star quality.
I'm really excited to get up there and take her advice and do it, and hopefully she's watching and she's like, that's my girl, she did it. I'm proud.
Well, this one turned Diana into the disco diva with Love Hangover. Here's Stephanie.
If there's a cure for this, I don't want it, don't want it. If there's a cure for this, I don't want it, don't want it. Think about it all the time. I never let it out of my mind, 'cause I love you. I've got the sweetest hangover, and I don't want to get over the sweetest hangover.
Yeah.
say.
All right, so yo, it's been a kind of an interesting night with forgetting a little bit of the words tonight, yeah? It's been very interesting tonight. I don't know, Paul, it's been very funny. It was a good vocal. I don't think it was your best vocal. It was a strong finish, but it was a perfect choice for you. I don't know. I was waiting for the up-tempo part to start, and I was like, yo, come on.
Is there a reason why you didn't do it? I think the whole, everyone was, because we all love that song and wait for that. What was there an artistic choice as to why not?
It was just longer, like kind of too long to kind of fit it in to.
Yeah.
But that's what arranging is for.
Yeah.
I mean, you have strong vocals.
Thank you.
Without a doubt, but keep going. You know, strive for better. Strive for better.
Okay.
You have a beautiful voice.
Thank you.
It was a very strange arrangement of the song because you teased everybody with the good part and then you failed to deliver. So basically what you sang was an intro.
Yeah.
And it didn't close particularly well. I think you were completely outsung by Lakeisha and Melinda tonight. It wasn't your best performance. And you had a multitude of amazing Diana Ross songs to choose from. And you chose, in my opinion, the wrong song. And you're going to have to make a much, much bigger impact at this stage of the competition, Steph.
Okay, thank you.
Stephanie Edwards, come on over here, Stephanie. Let's hear it for Stephanie. Have a seat, quick chat. So, the arrangement, how much control do you have over that?
You have a lot of control over it. It's just that once it got to the whole disco part of the song, it was kind of like a lot of music and just ad-libbing, and I kind of wanted to sing the verses and the melody of the song, so.
Well, let's see if you get a shot to do something next week, all right?
Yeah, let's see.
And arrange another one. Right. Okay, for Stephanie, 1-866-IDOLS-10, 1-866-436-5710, or you can text the word VOTE to 5710. Good luck to you, Stephanie. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, next, what advice did Diana have for Chris?
Hello.
I'm Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Oh, it's a pleasure meeting you.
And you too.
Oh, I'm going to be singing The Boss.
All right.
I don't really get starstruck, but I was with her for some reason.
Take a deep breath, and then you don't have to be nervous around me. Because I'm not any different than you, except I'm older.
But when I was singing to her, I was thinking, you know, does she like it?
Show me who was the boss.
Or am I completely butchering her song in front of her face? Like, I was waiting for her to stop me and be like, you know, that's just horrible. I'm still putting it together.
I like it very much.
Oh, thank
very
you. Much. Thank very you so much.
Yeah. One, he needs to define where the hook is in the song, and he needs to work the song. And are you going to work the audience?
I hope so.
This is a work the audience kind of song. He's got to move around a bit on that song. In other words, move around to sell the song to the audience. But anyway, it sounds really good. Just keep your head in a good place. It's important.
Thank you so much.
Right.
It was
very
so
welcome.
Nice meeting you.
And you too. Very much.
Oh, he's got the big stage. Let's see if he can work it singing The Boss. Here's Chris Richardson.
Fancy me. Never thought I'd agree. In love and how love had to be run. Had a 1-7 plan to prove it. Oh, got in my pocket for fools, folly and fun. But love had to show me one thing. And I was so right. Oh, I can turn emotions on and off. I was so
Well, Chris, yo, dog, I tell you what. You definitely kind of holding the line for the boys tonight. I mean, it wasn't my favorite performance of yours because I think you overdid it a little bit. Sometimes you can sing the melody without singing a lot of runs, but the runs you did connect on were hot. But, you know, it was interesting for me. It was kind of half and half, half good, half bad for me.
I think out of all the guys, you nailed the blend of bringing contemporary into... And it was fun. There's a song back in the day that Dan Hartman Instant Replay vibe. And it was real, it was one of the best dance songs. And you kind of turned it into that direction. And you played with the vocals and you did a great job.
Chris, remembering this is a singing competition, take you out the equation with your charm and personality. Listen to the vocals. I thought it was dreadful. I did. Once again, if you heard that record in isolation on the radio, you would switch to the nearest channel instantly. It really was. I thought it was terrible. Terrible.
Okay, Chris, America decides. If you like Chris, 1-866-IDOLS-11, 1-866-436-5711, or you can text or vote to 5711, but you can't do it until we open the lines in just a bit. Good luck to you, Chris. Thank you very much, all right? The break. Welcome back to Idol. It's the last number before we open the lines. What was the chemistry like between Diana and Jordan? Let's see.
Can I hug you?
Yes! Okay.
This week, I'm going to be showing my softer side by singing If We Hold On Together.
Don't lose your way with each passing day.
I think Jordan is absolutely gorgeous, but you need to be able to project a song, got to be able to look at the audience and really believe and own the words of the song. Tell them the story. Don't lose your way with each passing day. Talk to them, okay, but through the song.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Totally
take that to heart. I'm definitely going to apply Ms. Ross's advice, thinking about who really makes me feel the song and what it means to me.
I wanted her very much to know that her projection was very important. And to me, she has star quality because of her smile. And you see the glitter, the shine in her eyes. So she has an inner light, which is very important.
This song was featured in The Land Before Time with If We Hold On Together. Here's Jordan.
Passing day, you've come so far. Don't throw it away. Live your story, faith, hope, and glory. Hold to the truth in your heart. If we hold on. I know our dreams will never die.
Jordan Sparks. I tell you what, I've been a fan of yours since day one, and we saw you in Seattle, and I'm saying at 17, I'm just so, so very impressed with you. And I mean, a lot of people maybe think that this is a two-girl, Lakeisha and Melinda race on the girl side. Tonight, with that, you just made it a three-girl race.
As I've said before, you are a natural gift. You are like a breath of fresh air, and you're beautiful, and you can sing your little heart out. I wasn't that familiar with that song, but it doesn't matter because you drew me in right away.
Oh, gosh, thank you.
It was a little bit gooey, I thought, the song.
Gooey. Totally,
you know what I mean? A little bit gooey. But having said that, I totally agree with what the guy said. I thought it was a very, very good vocal.
Thank you. And
absolutely, you have put yourself in with a shot of being in the finals of this competition.
Jordan Sparks.
It has been so fun to watch you grow on this show. I mean, I think Randy said it best with the word impressive. Really impressing everybody each and every week. So congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You should be smiling like that.
I can't wipe it off my face.
Don't. Look into the eyes of America for Jordan. 1-866-IDOLS-12. 1-866-436-5712. With Singular Wireless, now part of the new AT&T, text the word VOTE to 5712. The lines are going to open in just a moment. Here are all the performances and the numbers one more time. Take a look.
You came good enough. No, we just have to wait. She said, just give it time. No matter how long it takes, but how many heartaches must I stand before I find the love that makes me live again?
Living here in this brand new world might be a keep me hanging on. I've got the sweetest cake.
The lines are open. Get voting. Now, if you don't get through right away, keep on trying. You'll have at least 2 hours to vote. And remember, these are 866 numbers, not 800 numbers. So dial carefully. There they are, your top 12, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you to the judges, especially Paula. Thanks to Ricky Minor and the much bigger band. Tomorrow night, live, 9, 8 Central, your results, plus Diana Ross singing live. Keep it on Fox for your local news. Good night, everybody. Thanks for watching. All right.